Researchmates, once again, I am researcher Jolene.
I am researcher Francine.
And I'm researcher Macy.
So for today's video, we will not be doing our usual classroom setup.
Instead, we will be answering our viewers' questions through our social media accounts.
Earlier, we asked you to give us questions about research writing, specifically coding. So let's get on to the video.
First, we will tell you the definition of coding.
Coding is the method of marking and arranging qualitative data to classify their various themes and connections.
In other words, you give labels to words or phrases in each answer that reflect essential and recurring themes, as stated by Aliona Medellin in 2020.
So basically, it is a way to organize the participants' responses into categories so that analyzing them becomes easy.
Now, what could be the importance of coding and why is it essential to our papers?
Let's have an example. For a particular student to choose a strand for senior high school, he or she must take an examination, right? This is done to help the student decide which strand fits his or her interest the most.
In this example, the strands are your codes, and the examination is your participants' responses.
The student's answers to the examination helps them be categorized to the strand most suitable for their abilities and their preferred college course. Thus, it helps them before proceeding to college. Coding is important because it makes your data organized and more easier to understand. We love an organized paper, right?
Absolutely. Now that we know what coding is and why it is important, let us proceed to the questions of our researchers.
Our first question is from our research mate at Nika _. She asked, "What type of research are you conducting? And what is the process of coding in your research?"
Good question. Actually, we are conducting a mixed method type of research. It is a type of research that utilizes both qualitative and quantitative types of research. Now, how does it work? Basically, we gather data through online video conference interviews, considering that we are in a pandemic. This type of data gathering is usually used in qualitative researches. And then we use these data statistically, which is normally used in quantitative types of research.
Since our topic is a phenomenological type of research, we are focused on the personal experiences of our respondents. After the data collection, we need to assign codes to the responses and form themes, then analyze them, which will lead to formulating answers to our research objectives.
Okay, the next question comes from at Lemonaz. What's the most effective way to code? Well, based on how we did our coding, we transcribed first our data since we gathered them through a video conference.
A very important point to remember in transcribing is to write down all that comes from your respondents. Do not miss a thing. And I don't
want to miss a thing. After transcribing, that's the best time to work on your codes. Read and analyze your transcripts and find connections and similarities between the responses of the different participants.
Once you've found the connections, you can then proceed to write codes. These are the words you can label the responses with. Basically, it shortens the responses into simple answers.
Then, once you have collated all the codes, next thing to do is to form a theme. This is broader than the code. It is basically categories to group the codes.
Okay, next question, which is from at Bakane. Can you analyze data without codes?
Based on Alan Patenot, who graduated with a PhD degree and is currently an independent scholar, the answer leads toward a no. No, you can analyze data without coding.
That's so. Well, he agrees to other scholar that transcriptions is a first level coding, which is true in our case because in the transcription we made, we had to organize the responses by what question was answered and who answered it. Considering that transcription is quote-unquote a practice central of qualitative research.
This means that coding is already a part of research, specifically qualitative research. And according to researcharticles.com, in research methodology, data coding is a prerequisite for data analysis.
Okay, what's the next question, researcher Francine?
Okay, @_jotred_ asks, why is coding necessary? Well, coding is a vital part in analyzing your data because it serves as your starting point to formulate ideas. It's like creating the dots that eventually form a line when they are connected.
Yeah, it helps in grasping the answers from your data. It also helps in summarizing a full transcript into bits of main ideas to help you, as researchers, to better understand and analyze your data.
Coding is really not as complicated as it may sound, guys. As long as you try your best to understand your data and what it tries to imply, then it won't be a problem.
Actually, research itself is not always as hard as it sounds. It's just that it has this stigma attached to it that when conducting a research, there is no easy way. That is why it is very important to study a topic that you are really interested in, because through that, you will always have the urge to learn more about it.
And now, for our last question. @ClassDeRoxy asks, do you have tips on how to do coding? We are currently taking up our research subject, and to be honest, it's kind of difficult to assign codes if you don't really dive into the data you have gathered.
For me, really, the best thing to do is to understand it by heart. Not just read and find similar terms, but know the idea that your data implies, like the real meaning of it. How about you guys?
I totally agree. Well, for me, you need to be keen to each detail, may it be small or big. It contributes to your paper because a single detail can change the result of your research. And as much as possible as researchers, we need to be objective at all times. Manipulating your data or your respondents through your research questions is a big no. How about you, researcher Macy?
I totally agree with both of you. Yeah. And I also find it necessary to know what code really suits the response, because coding requires that you get to the bottom of what the respondents really mean. And I would like to reiterate that objectivity is the most important thing in research, especially in the data gathering and analysis. So always keep everything, may it affect your results negatively or positively.
And that's all we've got for you in this video. We tried our best to share the knowledge we gathered while conducting research, and we hope that we were able to answer your questions.
Not only that, but also we hope that what we shared to you will help you better understand what research coding is all about.
We hope you learned and enjoyed from our video. And once again, I'm research mate Macy.
I'm research mate Jodeline.
And I am research mate Francine. Thanks for staying all throughout.